This is an ancient town with an 800-year-old compass-making tradition. An old shop that has recovered sophisticated techniques with the lost and found heirloom. What's the secret of Wan'an compasses? You're watching Wan'an, a universe in a compass. This is not average wood. It's called tiger wood. It must be preserved for at least 3 years before it can be put through dozens of sophisticated procedures and made into a Wan'an compass, which is part of China's intangible cultural heritage. Wan'an, one of the four ancient towns of Huizhou, is the only place in China where compasses are made using traditional handicraft techniques. The locals started making compasses in the Yuan Dynasty, and by the Qing Dynasty, the best quality compasses were made there. Today, there are still a few old shops in the town that manufacture compasses according to the techniques handed down from their ancestors. Today, Liang Feng, a research scholar who studies the I Ching, traveled to Wan'an from Beijing. What attracted him here is the WuLuheng compass, famous for its precision. However, he has no idea that behind the preciseness of the compass, there's a 300-year-old story about a meteorite. Located in Xiongning County, Huangshan City, Anhui Province, the town of Wan'an has a history of more than 1,700 years. With the Hangjiang River crossing through the town, it's convenient to travel from here to Yi County, Shu County, and even Hangzhou. Founded in the Yongzheng period of the Qing Dynasty, WuLuheng Compass Shop is nearly 300 years old. Wu Shui-sen is a 7th-generation compass smith. The Wu family compass and sundials are well known for their exquisite workmanship. In 1915, their sundial was sent to the U.S. and won a gold award at the Panama Pacific International Exposition. Liang Feng has reservations about whether the WuLuheng compasses live up to their reputation. The compass is made of a magnetic needle and a disc, the former showing directions and the latter the bearing. Wu Shui-sen promises to Liang Feng that the magnetic needles of his compasses can never be demagnetized. Once the needle is demagnetized, the compass will lose its precision. This would be a critical fault. When Liang Feng asks Wu how they manage to keep the needle permanently magnetized, Wu refuses to say. Like something out of a science fiction film, the Wus must indeed possess a magical lodestone. No one knows when and where they got it, but it has been passed down from their ancestors, and it's definitely not from this planet. WuLuheng Compass Shop was founded in 1723. WuLuheng used to be an apprentice at another compass shop, but he was so smart and quick in learning that he soon started his own business. Wu Zhaoguang, who is Wu Shui-sen's son, is now an 8th-generation compass smith. The Wu's ancestral techniques were carried forward by the 5th and 6th generation father and son team that made the sundial that won the gold award at the 1915 Panama Pacific International Exposition. Thanks to the precious lodestone passed down by their ancestors, WuLuheng Compass Shop has maintained its leading position in the compass industry. In September 1860, Prince Li Shixian occupied Wan'an and had a fierce fight against Zheng Guofan's army. In the chaos of war, Wu Zhaorui, a 4th-generation compass smith, left everything behind and fled only with a lodestone in his hands. However, he unexpectedly ran into the Taiping army.
湖南的太平军将其杀害，并夺得了这块陨石。那么，但是因为他也不认识是一个什么东西，就随手把它一扔了。后来被跟随上来的家眷呢，也重新把它捡起来了。啊，那么也是应该讲是这么一个镇店之宝，失而复得。
After they got back their lodestone, the Wus rebuilt their business on the ruins of the old shop, continuing this tradition. Guchang Rock, which is a landmark in Wan'an, boasts dozens of well-preserved ancient buildings in the Anhui style. In the Ming and Qing dynasties, Anhui merchants were the most successful in China and controlled the economic lifeline of the nation. Having amassed large fortunes, they set forth on a massive wave of construction. The past prosperity of Wan'an was a direct result of their efforts. Often, Hu Changqi, a cultural consultant for Guchang Rock, relates to the tourists the history of the old buildings.
那么这个房子呢，它的从建筑风格上来讲有四种风格，鱼池明代的，戏楼清代的，我们听戏的地方是民国的。等会走边廊出去一个门呢，是欧式的、巴洛克式的、西式的。这个琉璃。
Each building has many stones. Anyone who could afford to build such exquisite residences must have been wealthy.
民间有这么说。小小修宁城，大大万安街。它的方言怎么说呢？小小修腊月，偷偷猫嘎尖。这个什么概念呢？用普通话翻译出来呢，就它就是说一个县城原来很小，因为这个镇诞生过很多的徽商的一些店铺啊，所有涵盖了各行各业，也走出过很多的商业的巨子，所以这条街呢，猫嘎猫嘎，顾名思义。当地的方言就是这条街很长，像一条蟒蛇似的。按照这种风水说上来讲，它弯弯曲曲里边很有涵盖了很多的易经的一些这个基本的理论在里边的。
Small Xiongning Town and large Wan'an Street. The rhyme tells how Wan'an was far more prosperous than the county town. In its heyday, during the reign of Emperor Qianlong, Wan'an Street.Was a 5 kilometer long commercial street with various shops on both sides. It truly is a massive snake of shops. The town of Wan'an got its name from a hill and a pagoda in Guchang Rock.
那么这座山呢，就是万安山。山上这座塔呢叫万安塔，这个万安这两个名呢是当时吴王汪华给定的，因为这个万安呢是万事平安的概念了。
它这个塔是按什么方位建的呢？
这个如果从这块测量的话，它是按照子山五向这样一个方向建设的。
从罗盘上
看，就是这个指南针与底下的海底针重合之后，我们看前边指向这个字压的字。那么这个字正好压在五上，它也是按照子午相建的。
哦，这里有什么讲究吗？
子午啊，一般都是，皇宫庙宇这样一个正位。
In the past, before building a residence, people in Huizhou would hire a feng shui expert to measure the site for good or bad luck. While the external elegance of a building is easily seen, the designs based on feng shui are not as easily perceived.To measure the feng shui of a building, a compass is needed. In Guchang Rock, there is an ancient house that was built in the mid-Qing dynasty by three brothers named Cheng.
从这罗盘上能看出他这个宅子原来建的时候有什么寓意吗？
他建的是坐西北向东南方位，而且它最大的特点，这个宅子在整个园区的西北位。它的本意就是想在家里面发当官的，尤其是发武将。然后这个房子的第二个最大的特点，它是倚山背水。正常情况下，它应该靠山而建，它恰恰是背水而建。背水而建，为的就是发财。
The town of Wan'an used to be a ferry terminal where merchants gathered. The Wan'an Street along the river used to have many shops lining both sides of the street. Today, there's still a tofu shop on the street that has been there for about 150 years. Du Yanyan, the owner, is making Mao tofu, a Huizhou specialty. After natural fermentation, the tofu is covered with a fur-like mold, which makes the tofu more nutritious and tastier. The old man is very familiar with Wan'an's past. He recalls how the town got famous because of its compasses. Wan'an became famous for its compasses. And WuLuheng compasses with needles magnetized with the family's lodestone had dealers across China and even overseas.
This is Ming Dynasty. This old shop in the whole world.
The compass is not a household necessity. Only a few people know how to use it. So how did the WuLuheng compass from Wan'an spread across China? In the past, in spring when the water was high, it was only a three-day journey from Wan'an to Hangzhou via Xiongning. Wan'an owes its prosperity to the Hengjiang River that traverses the town. Huang Youyou has been a barber for 50 years. He still vividly remembers the stories his elders told him about the prosperity of the town.
Yeah.
就是水码头，这以前是搬运货，客运客到杭州，在运货上来，运货，全是小钱，大钱运货上来，就是商店都是店外嘛，都是，从这儿去杭州，去杭州，客，那是客了，运货也是上面运的，你好，运货货全是停在那里，运什么东西来呢？运啊，杂货啊，什么东西啊，布匹啊，都是都有啊，书啊，都是都有的，
多不多呀？多，那多的，反正都是店的，都是都是钱运过来的。
No traces of the area's past prosperity can be seen at the dock. It used to be a critical cargo shipping center of Xiongning, and even of Huizhou as a whole. Compasses from Wan'an and Usnia tea from Xiongning were both transported from here to the rest of the country and world. Compasses used to play a critical role in navigation. The magnetic compass is one of the four great ancient inventions of China. The earliest prototype was southward facing, which besides showing direction, was used in divination during the Han Dynasty. Shen Kuo, a famous scientist of the North Song Dynasty, wrote in his book about a few types of compasses. He believed that the type with a needle suspended on a thread was the most accurate. It is made by sticking a magnetic needle to a thread of silk with a little wax. When hung where there's no wind, it always points south. With years of experience in making compasses, Wu Shui Sen has recreated this style of compass which disappeared 500 years ago. The most important part of a Wan'an compass is the south pointing needle. Be it a sundial or compass, every magnetic needle of the Wu's owes its precision to their family's precious lodestone. But what kind of stone is it? Above the door of the WuLuheng compass shop is a traditional stone tablet that records the procedures required for compass manufacturing. The traditional process has seven stages, including choosing materials, rounding, gridding, cleansing, writing, oiling, and installing the needle. Although compasses now have lost their practical use and become collectibles, the shop still follows these traditional steps when making them. In the past, a compass shop usually needed at least 5 qualified workers. WuLuheng Compass Shop, however, has 8, each of whom has a specific duty and years of experience under their belt. During the process of compass manufacturing, one of the many exacting procedures is the writing.
但是这道工序的话，就是书写盘面。那么每一我们老店的每一面楼盘都是手工用毛笔写的这个盘算，哎，那么细的。对对对，它不能有这个一点点差错。嗯，它全部靠它记忆。基本上就是像这都是老师傅了，基本上这个盘面的内容啊，大致的记在脑子里。
The circles on the compass involve knowledge of traditional Chinese culture based on I Ching, astronomy, calendars, and solar terms. The needle pointing at the characters in different circles means good or bad luck. Characters are written in fine fonts on the disc made of tiger wood or ginkgo wood. A 40-centimeter disc like this requires nearly 4,000 characters. Every cell and every character must be absolutely correct. People in the past believed that compasses could determine one's luck. With such an important use, how could the manufacturer not aspire to perfection? WuLuheng compasses are not only precise, but also strong and durable. The secret comes from the oiling procedure. It's a traditional procedure to seal the written disc with quality tongue oil. But in WuLuheng Compass Shop, the oiling procedure is repeated over a dozen times. After repeated oiling and polishing, the writing will be preserved. Given such complicated procedures, the shop can only produce about 2,000 compasses a year. However, such fine procedures are just the basic part of compass making. The core technology of the WuLuheng compass is the installation of the magnetic needle. In the past, daughters were not allowed to learn this step, and it was performed in a secret chamber. In order to protect their proprietary technology, we shoot from a distance while observing this step. This small object is the core of the compass.
实际上它就是指针下面的一个支撑点。
Even more important than the copper part is the installation of the needle. It, however, is not the biggest secret of the WuLuheng compasses. Wu Daoguang has been his father's apprentice for more than 10 years. In his late 20s, he's already a skilled compass smith. All the magnetic needles used in Wu's compasses are installed by either him or his father. The greatest advantage of the WuLuheng compass is the magnetic needle. The secret of its permanent magnetization lies with the family's heirloom lodestone. Few people have seen this treasure that has been in the Wu family for 300 years. Since the lodestone was lost and then found again more than 100 years ago, it has never been out of their sight. Lucky for us, we were finally able to see this lodestone on the last day of shooting in Wan'an.
这个石头，对对对，哎呦，它的整个毛孔啊，你看跟这个我们地球上的石头不太一样，它经过大气层整个充分的燃烧之后啊，比较粗糙，坑坑洼洼，
对对对，
啊，挺沉的呀，
对对对，
这就是一个磁石，
磁石，就天然的资源石，它针都会有影响，你这么远的距离，
都在动，
对你这么远的距离，它这些针都会有影响，
你看
它的磁性是很强的，
很强，
对对对。
Put an ordinary steel needle on the magnet, and a few days later, it will be magnetized permanently.
It can through the Earth's magnetic field, it can self-propel.
哦，它自己能充磁。对对对，所以你为什么看现在很多的就是古董老的罗盘，上百年的，甚至有200年的老盘，那么为什么乌鲁恒的它这个指针依然运转自如？哪怕盘面的话，就是因为保存不善，整个磨损重铸了，但是它的指针还是灵活的。你像一般的盘的话，可能盘面保存得很好，但是天池都停止工作了。哎，主要就是因为我们这个磁它的这个指针的磁性和它安装的这个技术，是应该讲是与众不同的。
The Huizhou River quietly cuts through the town of Wan'an. The past prosperity of the town is like an old dream. As usual, 79-year-old Jin Guihua walks in the barbershop on the street corner. 69-year-old Huang Liu Liu, the barber, has no plan of retirement anytime soon. 83-year-old Du Yan Yan makes tofu every day. He says that although he can't make a fortune, he's content with his peaceful and healthy life.
You said we
28-year-old Wu Zhaoguang travels to the neighboring town of Lantian to look for suitable wood for making compasses. The locals believe that a peaceful day is a good day. Year after year, their peaceful existence continues.